So, I realize that I haven't really answered a lot of questions, and if I were watching me, I'd be very annoyed because I would have a lot of questions that I'm not answering. But I'm not very organized, and I figure it would be better to go ahead and start uploading videos and putting myself out there. And as I get a little more organized and my thoughts get a little more put together, I can answer some questions. Hopefully, later today I can put up a video of all my symptoms, of a basic overview of my story of how I got Lyme and how I'm in the late stages. We think I've had it for 11 years. I've never been treated as part of the process. Medical community is slow. For 2 months I thought I had MS. Doctors thought I had MS, and so this was going untreated. I'm still undergoing some tests because they have to have multiple confirmations. I tested on the C6 antibody positive. They messed up the first Western blot, and whenever that comes back, my doctor wants to do a lumbar puncture since my primary manifestations are neurological, although in the past month I have developed arthritis in most of my joints, which is cyclical just like everything else, and I have some heart palpitations, so maybe that will answer a few questions that I know I would be really wanting to know, and I can go in more detail later. But it's taken me, what, 2 hours to get around and get out of bed?
Longer than
Something
that.
longer than that? Yeah, because I can't really move very well in the beginning. I'm very tired. And really, this is on my way from the bedroom to the bathroom where I will be using my makeshift sauna and trying to take a really hot bath after I take my morning dose of oregano oil, which is what I wanted to post my video about because I wanted to post how I take this and what I'm using. Because I'm using a particularly strong version, and the first time I tried it, I didn't realize how strong it was. And I figured since it was oral, how much could it really do? And anybody with advanced Lyme knows that you can have some pretty bad herx reactions. And so later I will share some clips of how bad that one reaction was. And so, after some more planning, we're going to break up smaller doses throughout the day, about every 3 or 4 hours. And then, combined with I use an oil of oregano that is the wild Mediterranean. You have to get wild Mediterranean. And just so you have an idea of the concentration, 4 drops of this has 112 milligrams of barbacoa, which that is the main ingredient that is the active one for antibacterial properties. Although studies do show that there are other properties in the oregano oil that have antibacterial benefits. A study from Georgetown University 10 years ago tested this with penicillin and found it to be just as effective, but you had to use the whole extract or you didn't get quite the positive responses. I'll post a link to that study. Here's my brain today so I can write down things too, because I've been really foggy the last few days. I probably should have made notes for this video, but it took a lot of energy to get out of bed, to get my stuff, and see, I'm getting out of breath. And so after a while, you just say, screw it, I'm just going to put this up. And even though I'm a typically kind of OCD, overachiever, very planned person, I am having to, I guess you could say, lower my standards on how thorough and analytical I want to be in the beginning, because it's either that or I take a whole lot longer to get out there because I just can't do things as quick as I used to. So let me go ahead and just do this so I can take my song, because I'm really exhausted from just getting out of bed. And usually after I go in the sauna and bathroom, I get very winded. My heart's really going fast. I don't know if it's the heat or part of a herx, or I'm not really sure exactly yet. It's obviously related, because I've never had problems taking a very hot bath or sauna type of situation before. So, okay, here we go. First thing I want to let y'all know, whether you're doing antibiotics or supplements, which I'm starting the supplements since tests are slow, modern medicine is slow in getting me treatment, and that's just how it is. For anybody that expects to walk into the doctor's office, and get a diagnosis of whatever really quick, it usually doesn't happen. Which is really frustrating when you're working with your boss and insurance and everything, because everybody wants to walk in there and you get your diagnosis and you start your treatment and then you just start moving on with life, and it doesn't happen that quick. So, first thing I want to remind everybody is make sure you take some really good probiotics, whether you're doing oregano oil or some serious antibiotics, because Lyme requires serious antibiotics no matter what guidelines you go off of. And I'm just going to tell you what I use. You know, I'm not trying to do brand placement, whatever. That's crap. Whatever. And so, because I might change my mind. Right now I'm using one supplement. Maybe I'll think something's better. I change my mind with evidence. Ooh, what a novel concept. I find better evidence, and I change my mind. So right now, I've chosen the Ultimate Flora Critical Care 50 billion active cultures per capsule, which has 10 strands of active bacteria. I'm not going to take this with the oregano oil. I'll take it sometime later. I just want to show you, because it's important. And so, let's get on to my oregano oil. This is how I take it. So I have an oral syringe, because this stuff is very potent. And it's pretty rough to get down sometimes. You don't want to do it straight. Not only will it burn, but one drop of this is amazing. My mom was like, maybe you could put just one drop in some salad oil and eat it on a salad. I'm like, no, it's too strong. So I just wanted to get it done quickly. So I get my syringe full of the juice, because that's about the amount of liquid I use to take it. It's easy to swallow, but it provides a good mix of the oil, especially for four drops. I've done it with eight, which, whew, that's pretty strong. So I get my tomato soup in there. I just use some tomato soup, organic, whether that really matters these days or not.
You're at 8 minutes and 45
Crap,
seconds.
8 minutes. Okay, I don't want to upload two videos. Okay. Because I don't have the energy. 1, 2, 3, 4 drops. Swirl it around. I ramble. Shit. I've been really shaky the past few days. I have my things all the way back so I can't get the air out like I want to. So I just get all the liquid in here. I'm having problems today, obviously. Okay, let's get this over with. I'm not getting my chaser ready, so this is going to be a little more rougher because I'm trying to get this over with. Woo! Okay. I like to use root beer because it's a good cover. Really, just a couple swigs is pretty good. I mean, it's not that bad. I like oregano, but what?
You're 10-10.
I don't know if they'll let me upload anymore, so let's call it, and if I have to make two videos, we'll just do that.